Hey guys, I hope you're doing well. In this video, I'm going to talk about the best video editing software for Linux in 2021. Now, I personally love Linux. It's really fast, it's feature-rich, and it's much better than Windows, to be honest. And it's absolutely free of cost, and you can run it on pretty much any kind of hardware. But the problem is Linux has very limited options when it comes to video editing softwares. But then again, things have changed a lot since last year, and we finally do have some really good options. I'm only going to be talking about three video editing softwares at this moment because I think those are the only ones which are capable of competing against the paid alternatives in Windows and Mac. There are other softwares as well, but they are way too basic for standalone video editing softwares to be included in this video. So yeah, let's get started, where we'll start from the least preferred one and we'll move to the best one. At number 3 we have DaVinci Resolve. Now I think people already know about this very powerful software. Now this software probably has the biggest feature pool out of all the three video editing softwares in this video. Now DaVinci Resolve is also very popular for its industry leading color grading and audio editing capabilities. The free version of DaVinci Resolve has tons of features and are more than enough to make all sorts of videos and even films. So we're talking about serious business here. So I'm going to list down a few features which make DaVinci Resolve a really good choice for video editing software on Linux, and they are the ability to stabilize your video with just a few clicks, one of the best softwares for color grading, the ability to apply LUTs and edit them, tons of transitions, amazing VFX and simulation capabilities using Fusion, really good audio correcting features like noise reduction, dialogue processing and a lot more. Now DaVinci Resolve falls on the heavier side and it needs quite a beefed up computer. Now if you have a budget oriented computer, then skip to the next two softwares. Now after all these features, you're probably wondering if the software is that good, and in fact it's as good as Premiere Pro and Final Cut Pro in many levels, then why the hell is it on the third position? Well, DaVinci Resolve doesn't really install very well on most Linux distros, and if you have an AMD chipset or an AMD graphics card, then you're in even bigger trouble. You're most likely to bump into an error while making this work on your Linux machine, and it's really troublesome, and that is the reason why I placed it on the third position, and I hope it improves in the future. So at number 2 we have Kden Live, and I personally love Kden Live. It's free, it's open source, it's lightweight, and most importantly, it's very very easy to install on a Linux machine. In fact, most distros list Kden Live as the preferred video editor in their app stores. So any newcomer in the Linux world can easily install this software without any issues. Now Kden Live packs a ton of features. Let's talk about all the general features which are actually useful in most of the video editors, and I'm going to list them out. Chroma key for removing those blue and green screen from your video backgrounds. Motion tracking if you want to track the motion of a particular object in your video. Spot removal to remove those unnecessary objects of your video like lens dirts, birds or other artifacts. Masking and rotoscoping which are really very useful to make some cool video effects. 3D compositing to turn anything 2D into 3D and make them look futuristic. I often do that with my screenshots if you notice. Noise removal, which often lacks in many free video editors, but this handy little feature is available here. It also has quite a lot of free add-ons which include transitions, overlays and other useful stuff. And of course it also has all the basic features like blur, text effects, keyframe animations, etc. Kden Live is also really good for color grading as it has almost all the features like the classic color wheels, the ability to apply LUTs and hue saturation controls. Now Kden Live is also really good for tweaking with the audio, but it does lack on a dedicated noise reduction feature for audio. Now a lot of people ask this question on a regular basis, does Kden Live work on a dual monitor setup? And the answer is yes, it does. It works without any kind of issues. So overall, Kden Live is a really good choice for video editing on Linux. But there are a few things which I don't really like about this software, and the interface looks quite a bit outdated. Now don't get me wrong, it's properly arranged and nothing is cluttered, but I think the next software does it much better. And Kden Live also works on low-end computers, so hardware limitation shouldn't be an issue. So my pick for the best video editing software in Linux would go to Shotcut, as it goes very close to the paid alternatives like Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro on Windows or Mac. It's very feature rich and again, it can be installed very easily. Now I choose this as the best software simply because of how well it runs on low-end computers, and it runs even better than Kden Live, and also because of how many useful features it has, and I'm going to list them out again. Chroma key just like Kden Live, video stabilization which is actually lacking in Kden Live. I mean you do have motion tracking, but a one-click solution is much faster and much better to be honest. Video noise removal, and there are three ways to remove the noise so you have a lot of flexibility. Really good text animations and tons of transitions. You also have rotoscoping and masking just like Kden Live. And there are some extra useful features like glow, vignette, time remapping and keyframing. Now unfortunately Shotcut isn't as good as Kden Live when it comes to 3D compositing. Kden Live is much better and has much more features in that aspect. The color grading features on this software are very similar to Kden Live, and it also works on dual monitor setup. It also features audio and video scopes for the nerds out there. The interface of Shotcut is a bit better and well organized as compared to Kden Live's. In terms of audio, again, Kden Live and Shotcut are very similar. Now if you compare both Shotcut and Kden Live with DaVinci Resolve when it comes to audio, DaVinci Resolve is much better. But then again, you'll have to be very lucky to make DaVinci Resolve work on your Linux computer. So all in all, these are the three best video editing softwares for Linux which are capable of giving you the full and proper video editing experience. Now there are other options like Flowblade, OpenShot or Blender, but they are way too lackluster and basic for me to include them. Anyway, I hope this video has helped you to decide which software to go for on your Linux machine, and why not just try all three of them while you're at it and see which one suits you better. So if you love this video, subscribe to the channel. If you like this video, give a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.